We're here at Kiel Golf Centre with TG Test Pro Neil Wayne, and we've been able to get our hands on the new TaylorMade SIM 2 drivers. Before we get out testing, let us give you the lowdown on what you need to know about them. TaylorMade SIM 2 drivers, where have they actually come from? Well, they've been built on pretty good foundations, Neil.
Yeah, and when we talk about technology and just the things behind these drivers is unbelievable. Let's wind the clock back, 2016 M1, starting with carbon crown. Then we introduced carbon crown, carbon sole. Then onto twist face. Then twist face with speed injection. And last year they looked at aerodynamics. And now, even more tech in there, deconstruction. And when we have a quick look at this, I'm holding here now, and you can actually take this thing apart. It's so impressive.
Absolutely,
isn't it?
Amazing.
Where the journey that they've come on.
So what TaylorMade have basically done is they've broken drivers down into every individual component they possibly can do. And exactly the same as what an F1 team would do with their cars. So F1 cars are made up of 80,000 components. What TaylorMade have done is they've looked at every possible way they can do to break this down to improve tiny, tiny amounts to optimize not just speed, but the forgiveness as well. And that pretty much really feels what this story is about, Neil. They're chasing extra forgiveness rather than just chasing speed and distance.
Mm. Which is what we're looking for. Listen, even at top level, guys are miss-hitting and if you can maintain ball speed and yardage from your miss-hits, you're going to make the game a lot easier. Too many guys are getting carried away with, oh, I can get a driver that's X amount of years old and still it is as far as a current. Yeah, remember, there's a legal limit to how fast this golf ball can come off the face, but I can guarantee the tech nowadays in terms of stabilising drivers and drop-offs, they're way ahead.
Okay, so that's a story that runs through all three different models. Let us just tell you a little bit about what you need to know about each of them. Right, there's three new SIM 2 models, Neil. Just talk us through what's new about them.
Yeah, so, I mean, straight away, TaylorMade, I think they've got every single golfer covered here with these three models, from your elite striker, loads of ball speed, to your guy who's probably new to the game, sprays it a little bit over the face. Well, let's start with the SIM 2. Mm-hmm. The thing that's striking me the most here is the 5% more MOI than the original SIM driver. For me, that's a big, doesn't sound much 5%, but that's a big increase.
And what TaylorMade really wanted was to be able to give more difference between the three different models as well. Mm. You know, so the lower spinning SIM 2 is much lower spinning than what the SIM Max is.
Yeah.
You know, and then the Max is different compared to the Max D. So three.
A lot more of a broader models. Thing then, haven't you? As if you've got the three that perform relatively similar, mm-hmm. and you're not really targeting much of that. That's why I'm saying I think the more of the golfing market now can really get their specs dialed in with these drivers.
Okay, so thanks to the new construction with the aluminium ring at the back, that means you get 5% more MOI compared to the previous model.
Mm.
On to the SIM 2 Max, just tell us about it.
Yeah, so again, 5% larger face. So you've got the bigger face, a little bit more spin, and 3% higher up on the MOI. So again, it's a better improvement. You're going to get probably a little bit more spin. Mm-hmm. Maybe a little bit more peak height, but again, you're going to maintain ball speed off that miss hit, which is the big seller for me.
Yeah. And just a point on the larger face, the idea behind that is that you can improve the confidence of the golfer, but also you've got a really good chance to get more of the face at maximum speed as well. So that's just aimed at optimizing every single thing.
It's just ticking all the boxes, and it's giving it a little bit. Obviously a bigger area to hit the golf ball, do you know what I mean? It's going to give you a little bit more stability with that CG being able to be a little bit further back. There's just so many things that they've done there that sound like marginal gains, but these little marginal gains through each one can add up to quite a lot, can't it?
Absolutely. Okay, and then on to the Max D. So that's really aimed at the draw bias golfer.
Yeah, your draw bias golfer. So for you guys that don't understand how that would work, weight in the heel promotes a releasing action of the golf club, so they get the toe overtaking the heel a little bit quicker through impact, which will promote straight to ball flight. Don't think if you're a slicer, you're just going to start drawing it with a draw model. It's not always the case. It will reduce that curvature, which will allow you to hit it a little bit further. And another thing that I want to add with these, Simon, that a lot of guys don't understand, if you're a consistent misser towards the heel of the driver, then the D option, the draw option, would be a fantastic choice, definitely.
Yeah. Okay, and an extra 15% MOI, which
that's
is
huge.
Pretty impressive.
That's a massive number. Yeah. I thought 5% on the Sim 2 was a jump, but that's even bigger. So I dare say this is probably going to be your most popular one again, Simon, out of the three. I think this will be the most played, personally.
It should be, but I think a lot of people will buy that Max.
Do you?
Yes, yeah. Okay, that's lots and lots of chatting. Let's get out and start hitting. Okay, we've hit a lot of shots there. Just give us some feedback on each of the different heads, Neil.
Yeah, firstly, looks at address. I like all three of them. I couldn't differentiate massively looking at them differently.
It's a great looking driver,
yeah,
isn't it?
Yeah, fantastic looking. And even from here, like when you, it reminds you if it was to sit in the golf bag without the head cover on. It's quite, what's the word? It's eye-catching, isn't it? Like the design in there and the construction. Once I've got my head around the story and that and what's behind it, it makes me like it even more. But sounds great. Feels great. Felt like it was quite quick off the face. Again, when we've the shaft options, when we've played around with those, I feel like you can really, really get it dialed in for your requirements out of a driver.
Just worthwhile telling people that you're not really a low spin driver fan.
No,
played more Max model.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, in terms of a custom fitting perspective, maybe my ideal numbers in terms of data wouldn't correlate to what I like to see out in terms of ball flight. Probably a little bit more spin, a little bit more pick out is what I want to see. And I like to see quite a bit of loft at address, as daft as it sounds. It puts me off when I can't see much of the face. Yeah. But like I say, fantastic lineup. I really do like them.
Great. You really found that with the Max, that it did launch a little bit higher. We could really see it out there.
Yeah, it could feel like it was. And again, that's what I want to see from me. If we weren't looking at no launch monitor load, it just talking purely ball flight, and it looked like it was doing the optimum numbers for me. And again, felt great. Really nice sound. And it feels stable, which is what I'm looking for out of a driver. That's what we need.
Great. Okay. And then on to the Max D, which you've not hit.
No. I mean, it's not really aimed at myself, but like I said previously, I think this will be a very popular model for you guys that struggle from a left to right ball flight. Generally, a miss is a low heel. This is your option. Some slick looking shaft as well there. For you guys that are obviously your slower swing speeds ever, that lighter shaft. But again, fantastic tech in there. Do you know what I mean? It's aerodynamic and all. And sometimes what you tend to find is you expect to hear. When they put a little bit of aerodynamic technology in there, sometimes you can hear them on the swing, like the club, but you couldn't at all, could you? No. So it was really, really good. I'm impressed.
Great. Okay, so let's move on and have a look at the numbers then, because we've put it up against a few of the older drivers. So the original M1, sorry, not the original, the 2017 M1,
yeah.
The M5, and then the Sim from last year as well. Just talk us through what happened, because it is better.
Yeah, well, definitely. I mean, and what you've got to remember is they haven't put this to us as a distance driver. It's distance, it's distance, it's distance. We've gone for a little bit more stability, but because it's more stable, and I perhaps have had a little bit more ball speed maintained from a miss hit, I'm now hitting it a little bit further over previous models. And again, the technology in there, it's proven to work. The numbers don't lie, do you know what I mean? It's a very, very good driver, Simon.
Okay, so you would choose the Max over the standard model? Or
yeah,
the,
I probably would, yeah, definitely. Yeah, and to get that out there, like you say, for that's a huge jump for me. You look at previous models, 274, 271, now I'm up in like the 278 marks.
Yeah.
that's a huge gain, really.
Yeah, and just worthwhile saying, really, you know, that these drivers aren't aimed at people that bought the SIM from last year.
No.
You know? So if you've seen a four-yard gain, other people might see, you know, small gains as well. But it's aimed at people that have brought the original M1, you know, drivers before that.
But you will, if you have got last year's, you will still see a bit of a gain there with these little tiny increments, a little bit, obviously, larger faces and a little bit more MOI. It does make a difference, definitely, guys.
Okay, that is the TaylorMade SIM 2 drivers. If you like the video, hit the like and subscribe button. If you've got any comments or questions, leave them below, and we promise to answer every single sensible one. We'll see you next time.